They are my life.
Danielle Rizzo's face lights up when she talks about her two boys.
I've always wanted children.
Rizzo gave birth to her first son in September of 2011 through a sperm donor known as donor H898. 14 months later, her second son was born using the same donor from Iden Laboratories.
The donor's medical history, it was clean.
About a year after her first son's birth, she saw changes in his behavior.
I started to notice him stop looking at me in my eyes.
Her son was diagnosed with autism, then her second son. Determined to get therapy for her children, Rizzo searched the internet. She was shocked when she found information linking donor H898 to at least a dozen cases around the world where children were born with autism or other disabilities. Rizzo found at least four sperm banks were selling the donor sperm.
Who knows how many children are out there?
She also learned from other mothers.
The donor did not speak until after age three. I learned that he was diagnosed with ADHD.
She spent a year calling every sperm bank.
None of them would do anything.
Rizzo did more research. She found a geneticist who would listen.
This seemed like the perfect experiment to study autism in genes.
She's now working to get more families who used the same donor to give DNA or saliva samples for research. Rizzo also wants to see genetic testing become mandatory at all sperm banks.
There really needs to be regulation and oversight in this industry. And that's why I'm coming forward. This needs to change.